Today I'm going to bust some common fears and misconceptions about speaking up as an introverted engineer. Becoming more visible in your career is an absolute must to get ahead, so keep watching. Hi, I'm Yulia Eskin, a Silicon Valley tech lead and career coach. This is the right channel for you if you're a software engineer who wants to get promoted, become a tech lead, or just be a better engineer. Why is visibility so important to your career growth? A lot of engineers enjoy doing the work but don't enjoy talking about it. But if you want to grow in your career and do more and more interesting work but nobody knows about the work you do and its impact, then not only you're missing out on some great opportunities, but you're also waiting for somebody else to recognize you, rather than using the power you have and being proactive. Speaking up and becoming more visible is literally the first step to your career growth, and it will help you to get noticed, to get promoted, and eventually become a leader. But there are five other benefits to becoming visible, and they are: you'll be getting more responsibility, you'll be getting more interesting work in terms of the scope of the work and the complexity, you'll be seen as an expert on your team, and your manager will perceive you as a more engaged employee who is fully committed to the work they're doing. And lastly, you'll be growing your internal network so that you will be tapping into opportunities outside of your team as well. So what are some common fears and misconceptions about speaking up and about becoming more visible? So the first one, and that is the one I see the most, is that if you just do your work well, that is enough to get recognized and eventually to get promoted. But I want to tell you about a review done in 2020 by Access Perks that discovered that the top reasons for leaving a job is inaccurate performance reviews and being passed for promotion. Now ask yourself, do you feel that the extent of the work that you do and its impact is clear to your team and to your manager? So that come performance time, your value is clear and you don't have to go back and remember what you did half a year ago. And the value that you bring is really not just about the number of lines of code you've written. That is where most engineers get it wrong. The value of your work is that when you get assigned a Jira task, it's the research that you've done in order to solve the problem. It's the requirements that you've discovered that weren't clear before. It's all the gaps and nuances that became clear to you once you started working on it. And it's definitely not just the solution. What most engineers do is they only talk about the final result, rather than where they took initiative, where they coordinated with another team. These are the kind of things that become really important for career advancement. So don't lose the opportunity to highlight that to your manager and to your team when you are in stand-ups, when you are talking about your work on Slack, or any team channel and any other meetings that you have with your team. The bottom line is don't wait to get a reward for the work you do and to get noticed. Be proactive about getting noticed. And eventually your team will also start seeing the value that you bring and see you as an expert. The second misconception is that you need to be an extrovert. This is one I see a lot, but remember, most people, most software engineers are introverted in their nature. That's just who we are. Let's be okay with that. There's nothing wrong about being introverted. And people think of speaking up and especially visibility as schmoozing and as being sleazy or selling yourself. And it's really not that way. It's not about building relationships, although that is fantastic. It's not about hanging out with coworkers. It's not about talking small talk. It's actually about talking about the work that you actually do. What is really important here is actually learning what to communicate and how to communicating. It's about talking about the why that you're solving, what is the issue that you're working on right now, why is it important, who is this for, how does it maybe relate to other teams that are working on the same thing. It's about the approach that you've taken to creating that and remembering to tailor your explanation based on the audience and their level of technical aptitude and knowledge about the problem you're working on. And actually taking into account that you are introverted is a great thing about deciding how to communicate it. If you're not as comfortable talking to people off the cuff, then think about creating a written post about it and putting it into Slack to explain the work that you've done and any nuances and the approach you've taken or something that you've discovered that's not obvious to others. You can also write a document and put it somewhere and have people go read it. Allow people to come and ask you questions in person, because that is part of working in tech, that you're working on a team. but it's up to you how you decide to gather your ideas in a way that feels comfortable to you, that doesn't violate the way that you enjoy interacting with people. And lastly, remember that speaking up about the work that you do is not a favor you do to somebody else. It's for you. It's for you and it's for your career advancement, and you deserve the credit for your work. The last misconception is that talking about your work is showing off, is somehow like a self-promotion, that it's sleazy, that it's salesy. This is especially true for immigrants, and I think this is where it gets really interesting, because from a cultural perspective, American culture has a very flat hierarchy between people at work. That means that people mostly see each other as equal, even if somebody is a director and another person is just a manager or just a software engineer. In another culture, in a lot of, let's say, East European cultures, other Western European cultures, there is a lot more hierarchy between people at work, and that makes it a bit harder to self-advocate, and that can be seen in those cultures as showing up. But if you are working in the US or Canada or a lot of other Western cultures, pay attention to how other people behave and notice that there are benefits to talking about the work you do. It's not just about self-promotion, it's preventing overlaps with somebody else who might be doing the same thing. It's lending your ideas to an expert who might realize something that otherwise they wouldn't. Really start thinking about it, that you need to adapt to the culture you're in. Pay attention to what you are bringing from your culture and the beliefs you're bringing that maybe just don't serve you well in the country that you're working in now. And lastly, remember that if everybody advocates for themselves at work, and that is how people eventually get advanced and they get career promotions and they get into leadership, and you don't do that, then you leave those opportunities on the table and you really let go of the power that you have to advance yourself. So now let's talk about a few fears that engineers often have about speaking up, especially when it comes to sharing ideas. So the first one is that they will say something wrong, something unintelligent, or something that will be a mistake, essentially, that they're not aware of. So what I have to say to that is that you really have to consider the benefits of actually voicing your ideas. Think of it that way. By sharing an idea or asking a question from somebody presenting, you can prevent mistakes happening or some miscommunication or wrong assumption being made about the work that's being done. A lot of the times, the people who are hearing this information in the audience most likely have the same question as you, but they're just not brave enough to actually raise their hand and ask. There's a lot of benefits of you taking that initiative, because now you're seen as a leader. You're seen as someone who's engaged, as someone who wants to get the right solution. And so even if you make a mistake by saying something, that will often lead to a discovery process that your team will understand now what they actually need to work on. And yes, there's a little bit of embarrassment in saying something slightly incorrect, but it's through that process that you will actually learn what is the correct information, and that will lead you to become more of an expert than you are before asking that question. And the other great thing about asking questions in the meeting or sharing ideas is that the person who is often leading the meeting, presenting, is that if you ask questions, you make them feel important. You make them feel that you recognize their work, that you care about their work, and that goes such a long way in building relationships. And you probably know from your own experience that if you present something and nobody has any questions at the end, how bad it feels, because it feels like the information you share doesn't matter to people. This is a tool for you to show that the work matters and to show that you are engaged. And the last fear that a lot of people worry about is that people will challenge their ideas. As there's a group conversation and all of a sudden you have an idea and you share it, what if your team says, "This is not gonna work. I disagree with that approach. Here's why something here is wrong or incorrect." So first of all, there's always a risk that as you speak up, somebody might not agree with you. And I think that is just the risk of being innovative. Think of not only the worst case solution, but the best case solution. And first of all, let's explore the worst case. The worst case is that, okay, maybe they challenge your idea and somebody else showed you through their explanation why your idea may not work. In the process, you probably gain information that you didn't know before. Otherwise, you may have not had that idea. At the same time, your team learned something that probably they didn't know as well. So even in the worst case that that idea doesn't pan out, there is a benefit to your team. In the best case, your idea might get implemented, you might get more recognition for it, and that might even lead to some big career advancement like a promotion. But other than that, even if your idea is not fully baked, think of how much the idea can help another idea be born. This is what often happens when a group is doing problem solving. People brainstorm different ideas, and maybe half of that idea contributes to the final solution. You don't have to be right 100%. You don't have to know for real that everything you say is correct and true, because in innovation, the brainstorming is how you get to the final idea, and it's a group activity. So I really encourage you not to be afraid to share your ideas, because something there might click with somebody else on your team that might help them get another idea, and eventually it's that group problem solving that ends up solving the problem. And lastly, the bottom line here and the biggest benefit is that you are showing that you're engaged and that you are attempting to contribute, and that is so much more important than how many times you've been right. And I really want to encourage you to let go of the need to be right and just think about being a problem solver and getting your ideas out there into your team and helping advance the solution. So I hope that this was helpful. I encourage you to start noticing the kind of questions that engineers around you ask, how they're becoming more visible, how do they like to communicate, is it in written form, is it in verbal form, how do they give their status updates and stand-ups. Be aware of how other people do it in front of you and try to start mimicking and practicing speaking up about your work. It's the small steps that count. So just take the first step for starting becoming more visible, and that would lead to a lot of career advancement for you, and I'll be rooting for you. If you like this video, please like and subscribe and visit my website, www.juliaeskin.com. See you in the next video.